meet in God's name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you very much. Good morning and welcome to our weekday Eucharist here from the High Altar of Mitcham Parish Church. You are warmly welcome as you join us. Today, as we listen to the Gospel, we hear Jesus speaking about our reliance on God and trusting in the grace of God and committing ourselves, therefore, to following him. This is really vitally important, and this is what we call the leap of faith. So let us ask God to open our hearts and minds today that we may hear clearly his call to follow him. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and verbally magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. My sisters and brothers, as we prepare to celebrate the presence of Christ in word and in sacrament, let us call to mind and confess our sins. In the midst of confusion and doubt, we find your grace, O God, and discover your eternal love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
There is none but you to uphold our cause when our sin cries out and our guilt is great. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Reach out to us, O God, and we shall be healed. Restore us, and we shall sing your praise. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so to the collect for this following the week following the ninth Sunday after Trinity, let us pray. Almighty God, who sent your Holy Spirit to be the life and light of your Church, open our hearts to the riches of your grace, that we may bring forth the fruit of the Spirit in love and joy and peace. This we ask through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We pay attention to the readings.
A reading from the book Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Ask now about former ages, long before your own, ever since the day that God created human beings on the earth. Ask from one end of heaven to the other, has anything so great as this ever happened, or has its like ever been heard of? Has any people ever heard the voice of a God speaking out of a fire, as you have heard and lived? Or has any God ever attempted to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation, by trials, by signs and wonders, by war, by a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, and by terrifying displays of power, as the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? To you it was shown so that you would acknowledge that the Lord is God. There is no other besides him. From heaven he made you hear his voice to discipline you. On earth he showed you his great fire, while you heard his words coming out of the fire. And because he loved your ancestors, he chose their descendants after them. He brought you out of Egypt with his own presence, by his great power, driving out before you nations greater and mightier than yourselves, to bring you in, giving you their land for a possession, as it is still today. So acknowledge today and take to heart that the Lord is God in heaven above and on the earth beneath. There is no other. Keep his statutes and his commandments, which I am commanding you today for your own well-being and that of your descendants after you, so that you may long remain in the land that the Lord your God is giving you for all time. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, I will remember the works of the Lord.
I will remember the works of the Lord.
I will remember the works of the Lord and call to mind your wonders of old time. I will meditate on all your works and ponder your mighty deeds.
I will remember the works of the Lord.
Your way, O God, is holy. Who is so great a God as our God? You are the God who worked wonders and declared your power among the peoples.
I will remember the works of the Lord.
With a mighty arm, you redeemed your people, the children of Jacob and Joseph. The waters saw you, O God. The waters saw you and were afraid. The depths also were troubled.
I will remember the works of the Lord.
The clouds poured out water. The skies thundered. Your arrows flashed on every side. The voice of your thunder was in the whirlwind. Your lightnings lit up the ground, the earth trembled and shook.
I will remember the works of the Lord.
Your way was in the sea, and your paths in the great waters, but your footsteps were not known. You led your people like sheep by the hand of Moses and Aaron.
I will remember the works of the Lord.
Alleluia.
According to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples, if any wants to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit them if they gain the whole world but forfeit their life? Or what will they give in return for their life? For the Son of Man is come with his angels in the glory of his Father, and then he will repay everyone for what has been done. Truly I tell you, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in God's name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our first reading, Deuteronomy, today is one of those Old Testament books that can seem so foreign to modern readers. I wonder how many of you have read the whole of the book of Deuteronomy. There's the challenge. A thorough reading of Deuteronomy provokes a huge variety of responses. To simplify, it seems to have been written to recall the Israelites to loyalty, to their agreement with God in the covenant. Or put another way, to call the Israelites back to obedience. It was written during a time of confusion and doubt among the people because of the awful things that have befallen them. Does this mean, as many a TV evangelist tells us, that if we obey God, God improves our finances, removes cancer from us and family members, and gives the kids higher grades at school? Cancer, pain, bankruptcy, or unemployment happen only to those who disobey God? Well, the answer clearly to both of these questions is no. Any misfortune can befall anybody, as we really know. Despite the fact that such was Israelite belief for such a long time, they really did truly believe the more effort they made, the more they would win God's favour. Now, Deuteronomy and the Christian message gleaned from it tells us that a trusting acceptance of God's way means that we are in God's hands, no matter what happens. In ways we cannot easily foresee or recognise, God is working good in us and our lives. But if we but put our trust first, God. For us, the obedience we owe God is summed up in our willingness to accept and enter into the pattern described in today's Gospel, surrendering our life into God's care. Ultimately, then, means more abundant life. For it's all too easy for us to be persuaded that power plays and ingenious strategies, cunning and self-seeking are the obvious ways to happiness. But we know that's not true. Jesus teaches a paradox which sounds like nonsense to the world of politics and power-seeking. Those who lose their life for my sake, he says, will find it. By surrendering to the power and the life of God in us, we attain, better yet, are given a fulfillment we ourselves could never have devised. Salvation in the Bible, and in Christian tradition in particular, is not something one attains as the results of a series of seminars, or the practices of some guru, or the breaking one's back in a particular way, following rules. No, it is the gift of God that we receive. It is the gift of God to those who open themselves in poverty of spirit to allow God to work through them. So this day, let us thank God for the gift of his grace that he gives us, and let us practice even more our trusting reliance on God's grace. Amen.
Amen.
So now, in the power of the Spirit and in union with our Lord Jesus Christ, let us pray to our Father. Heavenly Father, as we come before you today, we thank you for the grace that we receive through our belief in Jesus Christ and in you. We ask your blessing upon your church this day, upon Christopher and Richard, our bishops, upon Simon, our Archdeacon, and Rachel, our Area Dean, upon the parishes in this Diocese of Southwark, particularly those in Merton Deanery, and particularly the churches here in Mitcham. We pray for St Barnabas, St Mark's, St Olaf's, and this parish church of St. Peter and St. Paul. We ask your blessing on St. Catherine's, Kingstead in Matabeleland. We ask for your blessing on all your church. May we be aware of the gifts that you give us, of the grace that you shower upon us, and may we use it to the benefit of your church and in your glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of this beautiful world in which you have placed us. We apologise for the way in which we treat it so badly. As we approach the coming conference this autumn, as governments seek to correct what is going on in the sense of climate change, we pray, Lord, for the leaders of the nations. We pray that they may act responsibly and with courage and boldness in making decisions which will turn the tide of the global warming problems. As we think of those problems which beset the world, we pray also for all countries as they suffer from coronavirus. We think of those nations where there is inadequate health care. We pray for those nations where vaccines are scarce. Lord, we count our blessings this day, knowing that we have the vaccinations here in this country in abundance. And for that we give you thanks. As we pray for those who go without, let us hope and pray that our actions, that our hearts might be moved in their direction to bring comfort and peace to them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for the sick and suffering. In particular, by name, we pray for Elmer Clark, Rachel Judd, Barbara Clark, Martin Chisholm, Joyce Pennells, Maureen Smith, Astrid Brody, Christina Bryce Killick, Maurice William, Michelle Chamaret, Claudette, Karen Pugh, Phil Parkinson, Dorothy Cummondwood, Betty Smith, Paul Barry and Chika Onuku. We unite our prayers with those in our intercessions book, and we bring before you, Lord, all those who we carry in our own hearts this day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear us, Father, as we remember those who have died, who have joined you in your eternal kingdom. We pray for those who have recently died, amongst them Rachel Samuels, Danny Gilhooley, Charles Clark, Stephen Ryan, Ron Clarkson, Janet Staniechki, and baby Finn James Kennedy. We pray for the souls of those whose year's mind falls at this time, giving thanks for their lives and their love and example. Rest eternal grant them, O Lord. And let light perpetual shine upon them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, as we pray for ourselves, we thank you for the grace so freely given to us. Give us the confidence to follow you in open and clear faith. Give us the confidence to be with you and to serve you all the days of our life, knowing that your grace is good enough for us. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen indeed. And so we come to the peace. We are the body of Christ in the one Spirit. We were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you very much. May peace be with you this day. Let us exchange a sign of peace with those who are with us, and otherwise let us pray for those who we do not see currently.
Thank you. salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendour and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours.
All things come from you,
and of your own do we need you. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Same day after supper he took the cup, and again he gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Jesus Christ is Lord.
Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his glorious resurrection and mighty ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Mother of God, Peter, Paul, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory,
forever.
break this bread, to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. Behold, Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. Holy Father, who gathered us here around the table of your Son to share this meal with the whole household of God, in that new world where you reveal the fullness of your peace, gather people of every race and language to share in the eternal banquet of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray to you. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise, that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to us. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen indeed, and again a very warm welcome to you all as you join us here at the parish church this morning. You're very warmly welcome. We carry on our services as usual, so this morning there will be an open service of the Eucharist at 11 o'clock, and again on Sunday we will be celebrating the Eucharist here at 10, followed by the main service open in church at 11 o'clock. You'd be very warmly welcome to come back and see us soon, we hope. We continue to have safe practices here, so you'll be very secure in that sense. And it's been lovely to welcome people slowly returning to our church community in the flesh, as it were. But please also be assured that these broadcasts will continue for a while anyway, until we are completely clear that things are well. Our Holy Habits tonight continues as we look at the prayer of the people of the early church. There are some readings for you to read, actually listed in the newsletter, and there is a link there for you to use to tune in to our Zoom link. So we look forward to seeing you this evening. I will ask you, however, to actually just double check your emails this afternoon, as there may be a new link to be given out, as we think our Zoom link may have actually expired and you may need a new one. So if you're planning to come on tonight and you're hearing me here, please do just check your emails. We may be sending you a new link this afternoon. Meanwhile, I hope you keep safe and keep well this coming week. May God's blessing go with you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your heart and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you now and always.
Amen.
Now go in peace.
love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.